Hey, what's up, guys? It's Perfect in Between here, bringing you some Mass Effect 3 multiplayer. Because it's something different, and like I said in my previous ACR video, I said I wasn't going to do any more ACR videos until October. So, anyway, this is from the new Earth DLC. This is Firebase Vancouver. I'm playing as one of the new characters of Fury. Because it's the only character I actually got from the new DLC, which is kind of disappointing. I was hoping for the Slayer as well. But anyway, at the time of recording this, I think I was level 12 with this character because I promoted all my characters after downloading the DLC to get some levels. And so yeah, this is the first time I used the Fury. And so my overall first impression in regards to using the Fury is that it is very squishy, at least in the lower levels, unless you do put points in fitness. I was gonna go 3 points in fitness, but having played it, and because my playstyle is I like to get into people's faces. And just ignore me, I'm using one of the glitches in the game to get rid of the rocket. I like to get into people's faces, get in there, do some melees. And the Fury just really doesn't have enough bulk, in my opinion, to do it. And plus it's got the ability... It's one of its abilities being Annihilation Field, which is mapped to Y, is essentially a warp effect if enemies get too close to you. At least the way I see it is that you do want to get up close and personal to enemies, and when you do one of the dodge animations, you'll see that I actually teleport. So, that uses up barriers, kind of like the Asari, Adepts, Justicar, and Vanguard do. So, yeah. In this game, I'm actually playing with Laddie, Kira, and Sarah. Kira and I are both playing as Furies. Laddie's playing as a Slayer, and I just exploded in his face. And Sarah is playing as the Paladin Sentinel. So, yeah. But yeah, this map is Firebase Vancouver. Probably my least favorite out of the new maps. My favorite one is probably... that basically leaves London and Rio. But yeah, that's what I mean by... not Slayer, the Fury being pretty squishy. So, I mean, I've since put more points into fitness just because it is squishy and I do like to get into people's faces. And both Laddie and Sarah are down, nice. They both apparently walked over the same grenade. So yeah, in terms of abilities with the Fury, it's got Annihilation Field mapped to Y. Under the left bumper is Dark Channel, which basically functions like Reeve does, except once you defeat enemies with it, it actually jumps to the nearest enemy, as far as I know. I don't have the From Ashes DLC, so... That's basically why I haven't used Dark Channel before this. And then under the right bumper is Throw. I'd personally prefer pull, but as Laddie so rightly put, it would basically be a carbon copy of the Drell Adept and the Asari Justicar. So, at least for two of the abilities anyway. But yeah, how I like to play the Fury Adept is basically stick on Annihilation Field. As of right now, I'm not actually level 20 with this particular class because of the promotions and stuff. So, Laddie's just slashing bitches. Yeah, I haven't. I'm gonna put more points into Annihilation Field because when it's rank 6, it drains enemies' health and shields, and just basically everything. Kind of like Energy Drain does. So it functions like a biotic version of Energy Drain. At least that's the easiest way I can describe it. But unlike Energy Drain, it's actually a proximity thing rather than just simply slapping it on. And I'm not sure whether the Fury's melee drains barriers. I'm not entirely sure. I may be wrong. And I'm about to go down again because fucking Centurion's flopping their dildos around. But yeah, this was the first map I played on from the new Earth DLC. And for those of you who have been living under a rock, or just don't know anything about the new DLC, it comes with three new maps, being Vancouver, London, and Rio. New weapons, and fucking Nemesis refuses to get grabbed. So I'm just gonna Annihilation Field. And this Nemesis is just running around. And it's gonna go exactly in the same spot as it was before. Grab kills for days. Yeah, it comes with the Acolyte Piranha, Typhoon, and for some reason I'm thinking there's another one, but I could be wrong. And the six new characters being this character, the Fury Adept, the Slayer Vanguard, which Laddie is using. The Paladin Sentinel, which Sarah is using. The Demolisher Engineer, which is basically a grenade fest. The Destroyer Soldier, which, according to Laddie, is curb stomping glory. Unfortunately, I can't roll, so I may stay clear of the Destroyer. And the Shadow Infiltrator, which is basically a Phantom, so Shadow on Phantom Glory is pretty good. Not for Lightning, because I've only got the Fury. But, that's... Oh, and it comes with new weapon mods, so it comes with a pistol shredder thing, which increases headshot damage. I won't be using it, because I don't particularly go for headshots. Particularly with my biotic characters, who generally have pistols. Mainly because I just spam biotics. You would notice I'm using a Carnifex. I've since swapped to a Phalanx just because of the rapid fire aspect. Well, I'd say rapid fire, it's just got... I just find it easy to use in a Carnifex on this particular character. On most of my biotic characters, I've got Carnifex. Either a Carnifex or a Phalanx. Or in some cases, a Paladin. So, yeah. And this teleporting melee! Yes! Yeah, the only problem is I get surrounded by... It's kind of embarrassing. But yeah, again, N7 Fury is squishy as fuck. So, I haven't really messed around with Platinum difficulty. Fucking Atlas Stagger, hate it. I haven't really gone on to Platinum. I think Azzy, Laddie, and Eric and I are planning to do some soon. So get some credits and shit like that. So yeah. Then I failed to essentially get this Nemesis. And it completely ignores a biotic explosion like a boss. Yay, Annihilation Field. Yeah, Laddie, stop swinging that sword around. So, yeah, I'm not really sure what else I can say about the Earth DLC. Oh yeah, it's got a better area of effect melee than Asari does, which is good. Not that it matters. But yeah, one of the characters I really want to try out is a melee build, Shadow. I want some sword goodness. Fucking explode. So, what else? Oh, and, one of the first combinations I tried out, because I didn't have any of the characters, was a Turian soldier with a Typhoon, which is fucking glorious. So, this was the first game I recorded for the Earth DLC. The first game I played was the Turian soldier with a Typhoon on this map. And it just absolutely wrecks, it just shreds through enemies. I mean, damage per, like, if you get one individual bullet, and it's probably not the highest damage rating, but it's just undeniable goodness. And Lighty gets taken down by turret, nice. So, I think that's about all I got for the DLC anyway. Love that teleport melee. So good, if only I wasn't as squishy as I am. And unfortunately, Dark Channel doesn't go through Guardian Shields like Reeve does. I wish it did. It would probably be considered overpowered, but it'd be glorious. Turrets for days. So yeah, everyone in this group is sitting on their level 20s, and I'm just sitting there with my level 12 Fury. So yeah, oh, I wanted to... I mean, for those of you who are watching, I'd imagine the majority of my subscribers won't be watching this because they subscribe to me for Assassin's Creed. But for those of you who are watching this and are actually interested in some Mass Effect 3 gameplay from me, Rose Lady, who has just gone down to a turret, and so have I, are thinking about doing a new series in a similar vein to Squiddish's What the Fuck Is This Loadout set. So basically, the way we see it is that we will be doing... We'll be taking suggestions for characters and builds, and then do a certain, either a gold or silver run with the characters suggested. We're gonna start out small, so we're just taking suggestions for characters and builds, and possibly weapons, teleport. So yeah, if you guys are interested in seeing that, leave a build. A build character and possibly weapon. It would be great if you could suggest two for us, because obviously one of us might not have the weapons, considering weapon acquisition is all based on chance. So if you could suggest for example, a lead set and a support set, and then whoever's got the stuff for the lead or for whatever set will use that. Excuse me. So, for example, a Turian soldier with a Typhoon as the lead set and a Jell Adept with a Carnifex, for example, as the support set, and then Laddie and I will basically, whoever's got whichever one, we both have the Jell Adept and the Turian soldier, but I've got the Typhoon, so in that situation, I would take lead and be host for it. That's basically how it's going to work. I don't know why I'm explaining the logistics to you, because you don't need it, but that's basically how it's going to work. So just suggest a class, character, build, and weapon, then we'll go from there. We're also going to hopefully start a forum thread on the BioWare social network, so just so we can get some views and get some suggestions from people who actually do. who do play the game. So yeah. Oh, and the Earth DLC also, I'm pretty sure you're going to see it in this game. They added a new objective for waves at randomly teleport into fucking rockets. Into either waves 3, 6, or 10. Yeah, 10. Called Escort. What you're essentially doing, it's basically like the upload objectives, but you're moving at the same time. You're following this drone, trying to keep it into an area. And it regenerates your shield, stuff like that. It's actually really hard to keep track of that fucking drone, though. So, yeah, you'll see it in this game. And to be honest, I don't know why I haven't edited this. You see what I mean? That's why I use a phalanx, because phalanxes are basically good at fucking up guardians. So yeah, fuck you, guardian. And now Kira's down. Ah, the turret. Hey, turrets! Yeah, a build I'd recommend for Fury. It depends on your playstyle. So if you like getting in there, getting in faces and sort of exploding, then you might wanna get some annihilation field justice going in there. Obviously, dark channels are given, throws are given for biotic explosions, but for me personally, I like to have some bulk to my characters, so yeah. If only the Fury's melee, heavy melee, counted towards biotic explosions, that would be glorious. And Laddie's really disappointed that the Slayer's melee doesn't use, grab kills don't use swords. And when I first saw gameplay for the Fury, I thought that she basically like mounted the enemy and then did a biotic explosion on them, which would have been pretty glorious. So yeah, here's the new escort objective. And you basically just turn on a drone, and it is essentially an upload, like a moving upload. That is essentially what it is. And it's really hard to keep track of this drone. And fucking Phantom ignores. But yeah, so long as you see an Omni tool on your character, it basically means you're within range to upload to the drone. So yeah, see, I didn't even notice the drone was over there. I'm just glad it regenerates your shields, though. This could be a huge problem, particularly on platinum and gold difficulty. Oh yeah, I should probably mention that this game is being played on silver. So yeah. And this isn't even the best gameplay, I just wanted to get something out from the Earth DLC. And that Nemesis didn't stand a chance from a Slayer and a Fury. So, yeah, for future ME3 videos, I'm probably going to cut them down. Just because I don't feel like uploading a 20-minute video. So yeah, that's basically why. And I'm pretty sure that, on Vancouver, the extraction point actually changes from the area where that Phantom is to down where it is now. And totally disregard Phantom's melee. Unfortunately, the Fury's melee does not, in fact, go through Guardian Shields. But hey, you can teleport through shit, so I guess that's a bonus. Like, I had a brute charging at me and I teleported right through it, which was pretty glorious. But I will also bring gameplay from the other two maps. We play the succession of games on each of the new maps. So, the next game will be on London, yes, on London, where I'll be again using the Fury because it's the only character from the new DLC that I've got. I'm pretty sure Laddie's using a Demolisher and invisible missile launches for days. Yeah, Laddie's a Demolisher. He's either a Demolisher or a Destroyer. Kira's just using the regular human female engineer because she was upset that she didn't get a Demolisher. She has it now, but exploded for no reason. Nice. Yeah, there's a certain range on the Fury's melee, so just keep that in mind. And that's about game, set, and match, and I don't even know when Sarah disconnected. I like how I got full instruction and just teleported outside, like a real boss. So anyway, that's the game. I hope you enjoyed it. I will be doing more ME3 videos in the future. And I shall see you guys later.